The Los Angeles Times reported today that a federal grand jury in California will soon investigate the multi-million dollar record business. The story was promptly denied by the U.S. Attorney's Office in Los Angeles, but many people in the business have been called before a federal grand jury in Newark, New Jersey. They were asked about drug dealing, payola, mob connections, and high living at company expense. Here's a report from Betty Rollin on rich rock stars and the industry that shares their wealth.
The Shah of Iran? No. J. Paul Getty? No. The occupants of these limousines don't rule countries, don't make oil deals. They don't even make million-dollar movies. But they live as if they did all of those things. In their 20s, they are rich, powerful, temperamental, and pampered. They are the Led Zeppelin, a rock group on tour. And in the vernacular of the record biz, where to be merely big is nothing, the Zeppelin is very big. To get around, the Zeppelin uses a chartered 707, the kind of plane President Nixon uses. But the president's plane doesn't have an organ, nor a 15-foot mirrored bar, nor in the private quarters does it have two bedrooms and a fireplace.
Oh, I do like to be beside the sea. Oh,
nor does the president travel with an entourage that looks like this. The boys in the Zeppelin have been flying high for a few years now, and they feel their lifestyle is only befitting their station.
I'm a bit upset that there's not a pool table on board. Apart from that, I think this is about the best way to travel.
The latest estimate is that at least 50 rock superstars earn more than $2 million a year. But it isn't only the performers who are making all of that money. The people around them are cashing in, too. People like agents and managers, and sometimes people like mobsters and pushers. At the heart of the current scandal are reputed mafia hoods who have been after a piece of the rock action through drug dealing, protection rackets, and payola. Of course, no one has profited more from the rock phenomenon than the $2 billion a year recording industry. Scandal or not, the rock recording industry rolls on, and the stakes are high. Of 7,500 new releases a year, only 150 will be hits. So when company heads think they might have a hit, they sort of go crazy. Freak rock is big this year, so when David Bowie came along, a flaming red-haired self-proclaimed bisexual, RCA put up $100,000 for promotion and publicity to make the chance of a Bowie hit less chancy.
This money, more or less, is spent in the direction of radio advertisements, in-store display units, pictures of David Bowie in-store, more or less, so the consumer can see the product that is available. Underground news media, newsprint, and several underground papers, which more or less pinpoints the markets in which we're trying to take David.
With red. There's not enough red in there.
All the promotion, all the effort, all the money, all the shadiness, all the payola is to attract the attention of kids like this.
This is a Wednesday Grateful Dead tribute.
A whole industry turns on the fancy and on predicting the fancy of American kids with cash. And in going after that cash, some of America's most successful corporations have lunged, tripped, and fallen, and now face the prospect of criminal prosecution. Betty Rollin, NBC News.